Only four participants are there. Okay. Oh, very good afternoon to one and all. First of all, I welcome you all in the first lecture of science subject. Yes, of course, this subject is related to the pedagogy. Okay. Now tell me, do you really understand the difference between the course code 106 and 107?
No.
No, why? I think you have attended the syllabus orientation of FYBED, right? But still you are getting confused about the difference between 106 and 107.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, in the first year of BED, you're supposed to select two methods. And two methods which should be based on the subject which you have studied during your graduation level. You might have selected both the methods, for example, science and maths or science and English, right? So 106 means what? 106 means content, means actual content of that particular subject which you have studied in the school level. Okay, and pedagogy means what? That is 107, that is nothing but the pedagogy. And pedagogy means what? Renuka, I'm going to mute you. Priyanka, I'm going to mute you. Okay. Pedagogy means what? See, the 107, it is pedagogy, and 106, that is content. Pedagogy means what? Have you heard this word before? If yes, then please write your answers in the chat box. So we'll have small interactions here through chat box. Yes. Have you heard this word pedagogy? Yes or no? No. Okay. Priyanka and Ronuka both are saying no, ma'am. Okay, no problem. Pedagogy is nothing but the science of teaching. How to teach particular subject in a proper and systematic manner. You can select any subject at school level, even at the college level. So it teaches this how to teach particular subject. That is nothing but the pedagogy. Right, Smita? Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now I'm going to share screen of syllabus 107. Okay, my screen is visible to everyone. If it is visible, then please say yes in the chat box. Simply you can just type Y in the chat box. Okay, thanks Priyanka. See, BEd course code 1078, pedagogy of school subject, and name of this subject is general science. As you are the students from the science background, you all have completed your degree and masters in the same subject or in the various branches of the science subject. Am I right? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Okay. First, we'll see the various objectives of this subject. So, can you tell me the just difference between the objectives and aim? Yes, do you know the difference between objectives and aim? If we see syllabus of any subject, even at the school level, in the college level, certain objectives are enlisted there. So objective means what? Is there really need of setting of objectives? Yes? What do you think? See, I want interactive session. Yes, tell me. See, you can unmute yourself and you can answer.
In short, what, ma'am?
See, is there any need of setting of objective? You can see. See, you can just recall syllabus of any subject at school or college level. Certain objectives are enlisted there. Is there really any need of objective setting of objectives? Yes, I want your answers. Okay, directly you will start with the objective so that you will get the idea about the objective. Just, yes, it is needed. Rajkumari, she is saying, yes, it is needed. Okay. See, objective means what? To enable the student teachers. Student teachers means who? It's you. Okay. You are the student teachers. To enable the student teachers to understand nature, scope, and importance of general science at secondary and higher secondary level. Okay, so before going to focus on this objective, just tell me different levels of education. You might have heard this word again and again from last 3 to 4 days, that is secondary, primary, higher secondary, higher primary. Am I right? And I think you have clear idea about the which classes they are included at the different levels. Just tell me which classes they are included in the secondary and higher secondary level. Just tell me. No interactions from your side.
Secondary includes 5th, 6th and 7th standard, and highest secondary includes 8th, 9th and 10th standard.
Okay, who told you that?
Renuka.
Okay, Renuka. Priyanka, she is saying secondary means 5th to 10th standard. See, these levels are means what? A particular education pattern, it is followed in the India, and this education pattern, it tells us levels. The levels are primary level, higher primary level, secondary level and higher secondary level. Okay, please listen carefully because this is very important. The primary level means what? The classes 1st standard to 5th standard. They comes under primary level. Higher primary level means classes 6th to 8th standard. Secondary level means what? 9th and 10th standard, and higher secondary level means 11th and 12th standard. Are you clear with this? Yes,
Priyanka? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Priyanka, Rajkumari. Okay, this is very important. But see, who decide these levels? National Education Policy. It decides the levels, and the current National Education Policy, that is 2020. They have changed the entire education pattern, and now it is, have you heard that message or have you heard that news on the news channel? Yes or no? Okay, no problem. We'll tell
you. Ma'am.
About changing of the education pattern in the India. Just I told you the education pattern. See, nowadays also we are following this pattern, but the recent policy, that is National Policy of Education, decided the new educational pattern, and which will be followed in the India maybe after some years, maybe 2 to 3 years it will take. Okay, so this pattern, just see, I'm telling you the numbers, and it's your turn. You have to tell me the standards. Please listen carefully. 5 + 3 + 3 + 4. I'm going to repeat. 5 + 3 + 3 + 4. So this is the education pattern which is decided by the National Policy on Education 2020. So this is the current news. Can anybody unmute and tell me, so which standard comes under this particular education pattern? Yes. You can unmute yourself and please try to answer. See, it is, don't worry that whether your answer is correct or not. Just try to answer.
Yeah, ma'am. It's first 5. It's first, second, third, fourth, and fifth standard.
Very nice.
Then third means 6, 7, 8. Then plus third means 9, 10, 11. And last four one is 12 FY, SY and TY of graduation.
Yes, see, now they are expecting that graduation should be for 4 years. Isn't it? Fayu plus three, your good name please.
Renuka, ma'am.
Renuka, it's very nice. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
See, Fayu means first standard to fifth standard, then plus three, 6 to 8. The next three, that is 9 to 11. And next four, that should be the graduation level. Nowadays, the graduation, it is only for the 3 years. And in some field, it is for 4 or 4.5 or 5 years. That is the different part. But basic pattern, after some years, this new policy will be followed by the India. Isn't it? Okay. Understood the basic concept? Okay. Now, we'll discuss objectives of this general science one by one to enable the student teacher to understand nature, scope and importance of general science at secondary and higher secondary level. Okay, first tell me, what do you mean by science? Science means what? You all are graduate or masters of science. Okay, just tell me, what do you understand or what do you know about the science? Okay, I want some new faces. See, you can you can unmute or you can just show your faces to me also, because participants number, it is very less. Yes. Okay.
So ma'am, science means it is a study of biology, chemistry, physics.
Okay, science means it is a study of biology, chemistry. Good, Smita. Good. I want some new answers. Science means what? You can say anything, whatever you know about the science, just see it. Yes? Who is ready to answer? Priyanka?
Joined, can you please repeat the question?
Just tell me, what do you know about the science? Science means what? You all are maybe graduate or the masters of science. So just tell me, what is science?
Ma'am, one more answer is there. That is study, which is dealing with the body of facts as well as truth.
Okay, very nice. Your good name?
Smita.
Okay, again Smita.
Study of the natural environment and the physical aspect through observation and experiment.
Very nice. Study of natural environment. See how many things you are saying about the science. Study of natural environment through observations and experimentation. See, observation, experimentation, study, accuracy, systematicness. So these are the very closest words to the science. And simply we can say that correct and accurate knowledge, it is nothing but the science, isn't it? Okay, Archana, she is saying studying about the human life and its evolution, existence. Everything comes under science. See, our life, it is full of science.
Yes. I'd like to add.
Yes,
Rajkumari.
Yes,
practical activity, practical application or a practical activity of any knowledge is science.
Practical activity. See, if we see at that particular level, the equal importance is given for the theory as well as practical. Means what? Actual theory means where you are getting knowledge, and practical means actual application of the knowledge. Even though we are implementing knowledge in our day-to-day life also. Okay, Anita Rao, she is saying intellectual and practical activity encompassing the systematic study of structure and behavior of physical and natural world through observation and experimentations. Okay, let's have an activity. I'm going to stop this my screen sharing. We'll share the another screen. Okay. Okay, general science. I'm just going to cut this general. You can say just science. Okay, now tell me one by one. Science means what? When someone said body of knowledge, right?
Study of living things.
It's a study of living things.
Ma'am, study of everything surrounded by us. This is called actual science. Either it is living beings or it is non-living.
Can you repeat your answers? Study of everything
surrounded by us. This is called science.
Surrounded by us, okay. I want some new answers.
Systematic study of the physical and natural world.
Yes, yes.
Systematic study of the physical and the natural world.
Okay.
Around us.
Systematic study of physical
and natural world.
Okay, and natural.
Surrounding us.
Evolution of life, ma'am.
Natural world surrounding us. Surrounding us, yes. And the next is
evolution of life.
Okay, evolution of life. Okay, I want next. Yes.
Study of dealing with body of facts. Body facts.
Study of dealing with body of facts. Okay. Some other answers I want. You can say anything, whatever you know about the science, just say it.
Actually, it can be knowledge of any kind. Any kind of knowledge is science.
Okay, any kind of knowledge.
Yes, ma'am.
It can. Okay, any kind of knowledge. See, we are human beings and we are very curious. We are very curious persons. And we are always trying to know world around us. So for that, we are using different senses. And through that senses and with our communicable ability, we are getting different kind of information. Now tell me, how we can get knowledge? Can we get knowledge from the information? Or is what is the difference between the information and knowledge?
Information is just collection of data, and yes. Knowledge is a deep study of it.
Knowledge is, see, instead of that, we can say the systematic study of it. And we are drawing yes, something from, yes, we are drawing yeah. something that is fact, principles, theories, laws, etc. after doing systematic study. From the particular data, okay. So right. Yes, we can write the systematic study. Okay. See, when we say that is science, when there is a systematic and accurate knowledge, then only we can say it is science. So the word accuracy, that is also important. Okay, understood the basic concept about the science. It is very easy. See, before going to touch the actual syllabus, you should know the basic concept of the particular subject, isn't it? Okay, understood. I will share this in your group. Okay. Okay, screen is visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We'll start with the first objective. The objective number one, understand nature, scope, and importance of general science at secondary and higher secondary level. Okay. Just recall the different levels of education pattern, that is primary level, higher primary level, secondary level, and higher secondary level. If we see the primary level, only the environmental studies is included in that particular level. Then let's move towards the next level, that is the higher primary level. So basic focus is given on the observation and drawing the conclusions or inferences from the observation. In the next level, that is the secondary level standards 9th and 10th. So at that level, the deeper study of the general science is included, and what they're expecting, student can do experimentation and they can draw inferences by their own. Okay. And the next, that is the last level, that is higher secondary level. That is nothing but the 11th and 12th. So here, the study of different branches are there. For example, the botany and zoology, these are the different branches of science. And what they're expecting, after doing study of these different branches, or you can say the science subject, student, they will able to select their occupation. So that is expected at the higher secondary level. So it tells us about the nature and scope of the general science subject at the different levels. Okay. Now tell me about the importance of science. Why science, the study of science is important? Just give me your answer in one word or in one sentence. You can just write your answer in the chat box. Or you can unmute yourself and you can answer. I'm going to repeat the question. Why there is a importance of study of science subject? Tell me your answers.
Sorry, ma'am. Can you repeat this question?
Okay. Why there is importance of studying science subject? Science subject seekhna kyun zaruri hai? Bas koi to ek subject hai jo school level pe hai. इसलिए वो सीखना है, ऐसे कुछ है या इसके पीछे कुछ?
No ma'am, it's actually study of living and non-living things surround us, which is important for life. So that's why we study the science.
What we are doing, we are very conscious, especially girls, they are very, very conscious about the diet. Why they are very conscious about the diet? Because they know the importance of the different food items for our body. So that's why they are very much, very much conscious about their diet. Nowadays we are talking about the balanced diet also. Okay, so we can say it promotes the development of the students after studying particular subject, means after studying the science subject, different values developed among the students, like personal values, it can be social values, it can be psychological values, it can be intellectual values, etc. That is the reason there is the study of general science, or we can say science, is important at the secondary and higher secondary level, isn't it? Understood this? See, I'm just going to give brief details about the objective. Okay, should I move ahead? Yes
ma'am.
Okay. The next objective is analyze the textbook and content of general science at secondary and higher secondary level. Analyze means what? We are using this word, analyzing. Analyzing means what? Yes. Analyzing means what? Okay, do you know the word criticizing?
Analyze means to examine.
Analyze means to examine. Okay.
Examine something in detail so that we can explain about it or interpret it.
Okay, very nice. Examine something in detail. See, we are using the criticize word. The criticize means what?
To find any defects or faults.
I'm not getting you. Please repeat.
To find any defects or fault.
Okay, to find any defects or fault. See, we have to think about
as well as find the wrong thing with the somebody else or something.
I think that is critique. The criticism, you have to just criticize the person. So for that, you have to think about the both the things, that is positive as well as negative things about the particular person. Okay, so here analyzing means what? The simple meaning, it is the breaking down, you can say the examine. Okay, so analyze the textbook and content of general science at secondary and higher secondary level. First we'll take analysis of the textbook. Analysis of the textbook means what? Just I told you the meaning of analyze.
Check the topics to see what the topics are mentioned, how it is, at what level it is mentioned, because at every level the things keep on increasing.
Okay, see,
the knowledge keeps on increasing.
See, I'm telling you this textbook. So whatever syllabus is there, syllabus means what? Can you define the concept syllabus? Yes, syllabus means what?
Portion that is given to be studied.
See, actually the syllabus, it is for the specific subject and it is for the specific standard. And whatever syllabus is there of particular subject, that is reflected in the hard or in the short form, that is nothing but the textbook. Okay, in simply we can say the reflection of the syllabus, that is nothing but the textbook. So here, analysis of textbook, there are basic two criteria, that is internal and external analysis of the textbook. I'm just giving you example. For example, you can just recall textbook of any standard and just recall the images on the front and back page of that textbook. So whatever contained inside the textbook, the images about that content should be reflected on the front and back page of the textbook. So that is a part of textbook analysis. Understood? Hello, please give your interactions in between. You chat
yes,
box.
Ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. I will open chat box. So just give me 1 minute. Okay. Analysis of textbook. I'm not going to give detailed information about this because we are having separate subunit on this. Then content, we'll see the analysis of the content. So just we saw that knowledge, it is generated in the form of facts, principles, theories, laws, etc. So here in content analysis, what we're supposed to do, see, for example, the topic is, you can say, resources. So you can say natural resources. This is the topic. One chapter is included in the 7th standard of the science syllabus. So here you have to analyze the particular chapter, that is nothing but the or particular unit, that is nothing but the content analysis. Okay. We'll take the same example, that is natural resources. So natural resources, this is the topic. Then you have to see the place of that particular topic in the subject. The subject is science. So where you can include that particular topic, it is related to botany, it is related to zoology, it is related to physics, it is related to chemistry. Just you have to find it out. Okay. Then you have to decide the general objectives of that subject. You have to decide the specific objectives of that, about that the particular chapter. You have to decide the learning experiences of that chapter. You have to find out the key concepts, the knowledge means laws. If any law is there, what are the new concepts are there? You have to find out all those concepts. And again, the evaluation, each and everything is included in the content analysis. Okay. Understood about the content analysis? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Analysis of the particular content, we can say particular chapter or unit. Next is implement methods and models of teaching learning in general science. Implement methods and models. See, science teacher, he is supposed to use different methods of teaching. So here, for teaching different concepts of science subject, she should use different methods like, see, lecture method, this is very common method, but science teacher, she's supposed to use demonstration method, experimentation method, project method, etc. while teaching the particular subject, because these methods are very much important for getting understanding of the particular concepts. Okay, then models. In the previous lecture of 109, I told you about the models of teaching. So those models, they were different, and these are the different models related to the teaching learning. In this syllabus, only one model they have included, that is 5E learning model. Okay. And the next is acquire the competencies of general science teacher. In the previous lecture of 109, just you people, you told me about the meaning of competencies. Just tell me the meaning of competencies in the context of general science teacher. Yes, who will answer me? Just tell me the meaning of competencies in the context of general science teacher.
The science teacher should be able to resolve all the queries that are put in by the students immediately, like without thinking.
Okay.
She should not say that, okay, I will tell you later. She should be that competent or knowledgeable that she should be able to answer any queries put by the student or anybody at the spur of the moment.
Very, very nice answer. Thank you. See, competency simply we can say it's ability to do any task effectively and successfully. So here, what is the the main two words are there, that is knowledge and skills. So science teacher should have particular knowledge, updated knowledge about her subject, and the particular skills. For example, observation skill. She should have experimentation skill. Suppose student is having any query, she should reply honestly and systematically to his query. Okay. These are the competencies of the science teacher. Then and then we can say that particular teacher is having particular competency or having competency of teaching science subject. Isn't it? Then next is familiarize facts, terms, concepts, laws, principles in the general science. Okay, can you give me one example of fact? Yes?
The sun rises in the east and sets in the west.
Okay, very nice example. Your good name, you're giving answers very nicely.
Thank you, Anita Rao.
Anita, very nice.
Thank you.
Okay, terms. Okay, give me example of any concepts, laws, principle. Give me example of anything.
I would say arithmetic principle, Newton's laws.
Yes, Newton's laws. Okay.
Archimedes' principle.
Charles' law.
Yes.
Boyle's law, Charles' law.
Okay, nice.
Work, energy, power.
What these are? Work, energy, power. These are the?
Terms.
These are the terms, concepts.
These are the concepts.
Processes, okay. Photosynthesis.
Photosynthesis, what you can say, this is a concept or term?
Process.
It's a process. Okay. Okay, give me some more examples. Principles.
Okay. Archimedes' principle.
Yes, which?
Archimedes.
Yes, Archimedes' principle. Okay. Okay, so science is always in the form of facts, terms, concepts, laws, and principles. You never give me example of terms. I'm not going to give you example of terms. It's your duty to find out any example of terms and tell me in the next period of science class, isn't it? Okay, understood the objectives of general science?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Terms is scientific terminology.
Yes, scientific terminology, for example.
Everything what all we read is a catabolism, anabolism, metabolism.
Very nice. Your name, please?
Equilibrium.
I'm Equilibrium.
Yes?
Bonilla.
I'm not getting your voice.
Okay. Ma'am, I'm Bonilla.
Okay, thanks, Bonilla. Okay, I think you understood about the objectives of course 1078.
Yes, ma'am.
That is pedagogy of school subject, general science. Okay, we have 6 minutes more. See, this Zoom meeting, this is not paid Zoom meeting. So the time limit is there only for the 45 minutes and now already 41 minutes over. So should I move further or should I stop here? Or we'll discuss again, we'll discuss. See, okay, we'll have some another concept map about the objective. Let's do this work. Because it's not possible to cover both the units of this course.
We can continue for 5 more minutes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Just tell me what you understood about the... Okay, what you understood about the objectives. I'm just going to type objectives and tell me what you understood about the objective. Just tell me one by one.
Increase competency.
Okay, you just tell me the keywords. Competency. Okay.
Content analysis.
Yes. And now you will recall the another analysis also.
Examine.
Examine. Content analysis. Just recall another analysis. What was that?
Facts.
Importance.
Just 1 minute. Let me write it. Examine
facts.
Facts. Okay. Another type of analysis.
Implement.
See, we'll go one by one. That was the textbook analysis. Then.
Importance of.
Yes, importance.
Ma'am, just one question.
Yes.
Ma'am,
yes.
Just one question. What is the difference between textbook analysis and content analysis?
Yes, very nice question. See, textbook, it is nothing but the reflection of entire syllabus. Okay. If we see textbook, so many units are included in the textbook and we have to analyze, we have to criticize the entire textbook, isn't it? But in the content analysis, you have to select any one unit. And you have to analyze that unit. That is nothing but the content analysis.
Then what is the difference between textbook review and textbook analysis?
For textbook review, you can use your own parameters for textbook review. But here for the textbook analysis, there are the fixed parameters on the basis of what you are going to analyze that textbook. That is the difference between the review. For review, you can use your own parameters. You can read any textbook and you can give analysis of that textbook by your own, by applying your own parameters. But here in the textbook analysis, you have to use the particular parameters, that is the internal and external parameters are there. Several aspects are there. For example, if you see in the initial pages, certain objectives are there. And objective means what? After learning particular content, student will able to do or to able to attain those particular objective, isn't it? So after reading the entire textbook, if you are having that confusion that, see, these are the objective, but it is not appropriate regarding the contain. So in the analysis, you can give that remark for the improvement of the textbook. Okay, that is nothing but the textbook analysis. So certain parameters are there, parameters are fixed, isn't it? Understood the difference?
Is it OPVL of a source?
Yes.
Is it OPVL of a source?
I'm not getting you.
When we are doing analysis of a source, we use a tool called OPVL.
I think
evaluation of that is not evaluation of resources. OPVL come in there.
See,
Madhulika, you are talking, I believe, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, actually, I'm not getting you both, so I'm not answering to you. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, should I move ahead or should I stop here? Okay, let's see. Which topics about the objectives of the science subject? You should know the nature,
scope and importance.
Yes, scope. In the previous one, we have wrote importance, nature, scope. Then next, about the methods of the teaching. Methods of teaching is methods. I just told you the demonstration, experimentations, all these are the methods of teaching particular subject. So here we are talking about
the methods, and I would say methods and models.
Yes, model, only one model is there. We can write about models also. That is the 5E model.
5E model.
Yes.
And then you familiarize with the facts, terms, concepts, laws,
yes,
and principles.
Yes.
Terms, principles.
Yes, familiarize with the
facts, terms.
Rise with the facts,
terms,
concepts. Yes, concepts.
Laws and principles.
Laws and principles.
Yes, laws and principles. Okay. So this is all about the objective. Okay. Understood. In the next lecture, we'll discuss in detail about the actual syllabus unit wise. Okay. I think you all have understood about this today's lecture.
Yeah.
So should I stop here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Ma'am, we have requested for the Saturday's class actually.
What happened?
Yeah, we have requested for Saturday's class because we are working whole week. We have Monday to Saturday working days.
Okay.
So we'll be able to join on Saturday only.
Okay.
Because we are already teaching in a school.
Okay. So, I think Sanjay Shinde, sir, I don't know about the FYBEd, but for SYBEd, he took poll option. And according to the students' need, we kept this timing.
Yeah. We have requested in the orientation session, we have requested few of us are from school, okay. Victorious. So, okay. We have requested for Saturday's class. So, principal sir has acknowledged and he told Vicky, okay, he will organize the timetable so that we can get our classes on Saturdays, mostly in the second half, maybe after 12:30 or 12.
See, actually, regular time, if you see the regular time duel, it is from 12 o'clock to 4 o'clock. So, actually, it is in the afternoon only.
Yeah. On weekends, we were not able to attend.
Yeah, that is
so true. It would be good for us if you can post the PPTs if you are conducting anything.
Sure. PPT, see, I will post.
Same thing on Saturday.
Yes. I will post PPTs as well as whatever this maps I am making here. I will share these maps also. So, you will get a clear idea about your learning. Okay.
And I have joined your WhatsApp group also because you are my mentor in the WhatsApp group. I have joined your group.
Your good name, Anita?
No, Madhulika.
Madhulika, have you took admission in the college? Provisional admission?
Yes. I have filled a form. I have done the registration part and the online payment.
Okay. Good. Okay. Thank you so much, dear ones. Okay. I'm going to take pause here. And we'll see you. I will see you in the next lecture of the science. Okay. Please stay at home, stay safe, and enjoy your day and enjoy your weekends also. Thank you.
Thank you.